Hello, my name is Lucas Miller, and I'm a support escalation engineer on the Dynamics GP support team. Today, I'd like to talk to you about modern authentication and how it impacts you as a Dynamics GP user. Modern authentication was first introduced in the fall 2020 or 18.3 release of Dynamics GP. At this point, there have been several enhancements, so our recommendation is to get to the latest version of Dynamics GP 18.4, so you have all the fixes and all the latest functionality. Modern authentication has the benefit of being more secure, plus it also includes the ability to use multi-factor authentication, which is another level of security. Basic authentication is going to be retiring for Exchange Online and Office 365 tenants in October of this year. So it's really going to be a requirement to move to basic authentication in order to be able to email out of Dynamics GP. In addition to emailing things like reports and remittances, you're also going to be able to use modern authentication to email workflow notifications. And the Exchange functionality that's built into the MS Graph API and Azure Active Directory is what allows us to use this functionality inside Dynamics GP. There are two sides to setting up modern authentication. First, on the Azure side, and then second, on the Dynamics GP client side. So let's take a look at what that looks like on the Azure side first. So here we are at the Azure portal. You'd have access to this if you have a Azure subscription or an Office 365 subscription. And where we're going to be focusing our attention is in Active Directory in Azure. So we'll click on that. And then under here, there's another setting for app registrations. We're going to start by clicking on New Registration, and we'll give it a descriptive name, Dynamics GP MFA. At this time, we only support the use of the multi-tenant support type. And we'll click Register. The first setting we'll change is under Authentication. Click on Add a Platform, then the Mobile and Desktop Applications. And here all we need to do is paste in a custom URI that we'll have documented on the blog and in our documentation. You can click Configure. Next, we go to API Permissions. By default, under Microsoft Graph, we have the ability to read users and their profiles. But in order to send email, we need to add a permission, then select Microsoft Graph and delegated permissions. The easiest thing here is to type mail.send, expand out the mail permission, mark mail.send, which allows this application to send a mail email on our behalf, and add permissions. At that point, all of our configuration is done, so we can go back to the overview window. We have an application client ID here. I'm going to click the copy to clipboard button, and we'll use that in Dynamics GP. So in our GP client, we will go to the administration area page and then scroll down to the email settings window. Starting in the fall 2020 or 18.3 release, we've added a field on this window for the application client ID. This ties back to a table, the SY04900. So when this is written, or this is saved, it'll be written to that table. When I tab off of this field, the change script is going to recognize that I've added that, and it's going to prompt me to log in. So here we have our new modern auth login window. I will check an account from that Azure AD tenant. Enter my password, since I've already set up my MFA options for this account, it knows it's going to either text me or call me. I'm going to choose text. Okay. Since this is the first time that we have used this particular app registration, it's going to ask us to verify and authenticate. So this is where this first time login needs to be performed as a global admin from your Azure AD tenant. So we can perform this authorization process. So I'm going to mark consent on behalf of your organization and click accept. So at this point, we're logged into an MS Graph Modern Auth email session, and it's going to essentially act like the Exchange login sessions in previous versions of Dynamics GP. We should only have to log in the first time we perform an email operation in our GP session, and then you wouldn't have to log in to Modern Auth again until you close and reopen Dynamics GP itself. So in terms of the user experience, like I said, the user will log into the Modern Auth window one time per GP session. If you don't have MFA enabled on an account, you can still use a Modern authentication. You just won't receive that second prompt for a text message or an email or a phone call code, but you will still be using Modern authentication. In terms of workflow functionality, we're also going to use Modern Auth there. So when you are submitting something for approval, you enter the comment on the submitted item, you click OK. At that point, you would receive the Modern Auth login window if you haven't logged in before. Then the approver is going to receive the email from the person who logged into the Modern Auth window. It's no longer going to be sending as that centralized account from the workflow setup window. In fact, the only time SMTP is going to be used is we'll fall back to it if you approve a task from a workflow email notification. There's no headless Modern Auth functionality built into that email, so it will just send on behalf of that SMTP user. Some known limitations with Modern Auth at this time. If you print a report to screen and choose send to mail recipient as either a PDF or a text file, it's going to fall back to the old Exchange logon basic authentication window. And if basic auth is turned off on your tenant, that you won't be able to get past that. We have seen that if you have basic auth turned on your tenant and MFA is either disabled or set to enabled, you may be able to get by that Exchange login window. If you have MFA set to enforced for your user, you're probably not going to get past that window. So the workaround there is to use the functionality built in to Windows with an email button rather than printing a report to screen. You maybe also can go to like a reprint reports window, reprint statements window, and send them from that window rather than after printing them to screen. We've also seen issues with shared mailboxes. So if you've historically used a shared mailbox for all users to log into the Exchange logon window, you will probably need to switch to individual user accounts for the Modern Auth window. That's something we're also looking into for future release. In addition to that, the web client is currently not compatible with Modern authentication. And that's something we're looking into. We have had reports of people using third-party authentication providers, for example, Okta or Duo. Out of the box, those may not work. We do have some information on our email troubleshooting guide, which I'll link in our blog, the blog article, that provides some potential workarounds for that. And it's also possible that there are some ISVs that have not adopted Modern authentication yet. It does require some code changes in such add-ins. I know a lot of them, for example, McCorma was an early adopter of Modern Auth, so that should be compatible for you. But just something you'll need to check with your ISVs for. I'd like to thank you for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please do comment on the blog post or reach out to the Dynamics GP support team, and we're going to be certainly happy to help with any questions you may have. Thank you and have a great day.